champions. All right, this Tale of the Tape brought to you by VeChain, the official blockchain of UFC. Brandon Moreno is 29, Alexandre Pantoja 33. Moreno 2 inches taller than his title challenger, 2.5 inches in reach for the Mexican champion, Brandon Moreno. All right, now for the intros, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the co-main event of the evening. Brought to you by Diablo Immortal with an all-new class, Blood Knight. Our three judges in the contest at Octagon Side are Ben Cartlidge, Derek Clearly, and Junichiro Camijo. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Jason Herzog. And now, this fight is 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC Flyweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a big martial artist holding a professional record, 25 wins, 5 losses. He stands 5 feet 5 inches tall, weighing in at 125 pounds, fighting out of Bahia do Cabo, Brazil, presenting the number 2 ranked flyweight contender in the world, the challenger, Alexandre the Cannibal. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a big martial artist holding a professional record, 21 wins, 6 losses, 2 draws. He stands 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing in at 125 pounds, fighting out of Tijuana, Mexico, presenting the undisputed reigning, defending UFC flyweight champion of the world, Brandon the Assassin Baby Moreno!
We went over the rules in the back. There were no final questions from you, Blue. There were no final questions from you, Red. If you want to touch gloves, do it now. Come out ready to fight.
Even watching Brandon Moreno get introduced just looks like a different visual than years prior, right? World-class world champion. He is physically stronger than he's ever been. A lot of his training partners have acknowledged as much. And under the watchful eye of the general Saif Saud, Brandon Moreno looking to successfully defend his title tonight. Flyweight championship is underway. Pantoja in yellow, Brandon Moreno in the black and gold, defending a champion.
I wonder how quickly Pantoja goes out there to try to remind him, I'm the one that wins in these situations, and you saw it immediately. But Moreno goes to the body lock, and now he's got him pressing against the Octagon side. So much has been made about everyone's a different, Brandon's a different fighter, Pantoja's a different fighter, but at the end of the day, in those two interactions, he has gotten the best of you. So it lives in there somewhere. We just need to see how deep Brandon has been able to bury it.
Right. And Moreno wanted to acknowledge and not deny that past, but yep. In terms of strategy and game plan, he just feels like
he's a different human being. He said he was embarrassed watching the film at times. In preparation for this fight. You see Moreno using the clinch here very effectively. He's been training with one of my guys, Nick Piccinini, moved down to Dallas, Texas, has been giving him great wrestling rounds. Moreno said he's learning so much in that aspect of the game. And right now you see it with the great clinch work that Moreno's doing.
Pantoja knew after he submitted Alex Perez last July in Dallas that he might have to wait a year. Oh, nice knee by Pantoja out of the break.
Nice left hook there by the champion. The Pantoja corner said, The longer you wait, the more Quinn throws you, the worse he gets.
Good
nice combo,
there,
yeah.
Moreno.
Nice combo by the champ. Pantoja cannot take too many of those shots. I know he's tough. I know he's never been finished, but you cannot take shots like that from the champ. He's bigger, stronger, faster. He can put you out now.
Makarao and Pahupa commanding the Pantoja corner tonight. Everton Oliveira alongside as well. Nice combination by Moreno.
Moreno getting on very well in these exchanges. Long punches on the outside by Moreno.
Oh no, Pantoja drops him with a left hand.
Big elbow by Pantoja.
Oh,
he got him
with
a crucifix.
Moreno has been busted open. He is nothing if not durable, but a huge early moment for the challenger.
Huge moment. He's looking to pass the guard here, trying to separate, get that left leg free.
You see Moreno trying to shell up, not take any damage from the bottom. Work his way back to his feet. Pantoja trying to advance his position from the top while dealing damage. Moreno's back up to his feet. He's got to resettle now. He's got to reset his mind. He got a great start. Pantoja changed the momentum with one shot.
Good jab and a follow-up right hand. Now an uppercut from Moreno.
Another great combination lands by Pantoja.
Moreno's been in a lot of these situations.
Oh, he's on the left hook again.
Pantoja just seems intent on just walking him down.
Beautiful low kick. Left hook, low kick combination, uppercut. Oh, good left hook by the champ.
Nice jab by Moreno under a minute to go in what has been a furious round one.
I mean, what a great round for the challenger. If Pantoja wanted to set the tone and remind Brandon Moreno that he wins when they fight, he has done a fantastic job of doing that.
And now he's got his back.
He's got to try to drive him down to the mat. Pressure going forward. Hang on, Moreno.
A statement made by Pantoja in round one. This coach's cam is brought to you by Cuervo.
Look out. Breathe for me, champ. Get on that cut. Sit down. You want to sit or not? Three deep breaths.
Water. Take care of the water.
Look at me. Look at me. He's already fucking tired, you understand? He's already tired, but if you stay at range with him, you're going to get tired too. You got hit. I don't know if it was a headbutt or what, but you got a cut, but it's fine. It's going to leak this way.
We knew
we were going to bleed tonight. I need you to keep your fucking discipline.
Here's that big left hand by Pantoja that dropped the champion. And here's a big elbow that cut him open.
Oh, yeah.
On the ground. Big round for the challenger. Left hook by Pantoja that really snapped his head back.
UFC 290 Volkanovski versus Rodriguez is presented by Modelo, brewed for those with a fighting spirit.
Check them out, buddy. You ready? You ready? Fight!
Round two.
Saif Saud was saying that they believe Pantoja's tired. One thing we do know is that Brandon Moreno will not fatigue. He gets better as the fight goes on.
Oh!
Pantoja's really loading up, and he had a left hook there.
He is trying to put him off.
He caught him a left hook again.
Oh,
good shot by the champion. He's having real success with that long jab.
That jab, yes.
Popping it out there.
Moreno really starting to find the range. Beautiful job.
Can't tells you can't just wade in and take these.
No.
He seems to be the slower man.
Well, he's throwing so many big power shots, and Moreno's just kind of popping the jab.
Yeah.
He's not really trying to sit on every single punch he throws, and that's making the jab faster.
Well, Pantoja came out against Alex Perez like a bat out of hell. Similar approach tonight.
Well, Pantoja's got to shorten up those shots a little bit. He cannot throw every punch to try to knock Brandon Moreno off.
Perhaps Saif Saud was onto something in terms of that Pantoja fatigue. He's throwing everything with fight-ending intentions.
Yeah. And I just don't quite understand it, John. I don't know why. You know it's going to be 25 minutes. You cannot throw everything to try to end the night. He needs to slow everything down. But Moreno takes his back here.
Oh! Tremendous moment from Moreno.
What a bounce back round for the champion.
My goodness.
Getting right back to what he needed to do. Popping that jab, fighting long, getting the takedown, and now taking the back of Alessandro Pantoja.
Under 3 minutes here to go in round two. As we told you, 30 fights in, Pantoja has never been finished. Joe, what does Moreno need to do to adjust here, try to get a choke?
Well, he's got to get under the chin, first of all, but he's got a good secure hold on the back here. It's up to Pantoja to try to get out of this position. And in the transitions of getting out of the position, that's when Brandon Moreno is going to try to cinch things up tighter. But he's got to take his time and be patient.
Yep.
Alessandro Pantoja is a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt of the highest order.
I don't even think he's trying to finish it. I think you take your time and you control the position if you're Brandon Moreno. You don't lose this guy. Everything's trending in the right direction for you. Maintain control. Win the round. And let Pantoja continue to start to empty the gas tank. Don't force and rush, because you just give this kid more chances on the feet. And while the shots are coming wild, if one lands, you know he can hurt you.
Our coach Dean Thomas knows that ATT corner well. Dean, talk to me.
I tell you what, this might be actually better for Moreno. Because if he just had his back, Pantoja was going to rest. But now he's going to make him work. So this is better for Moreno to get into an action like this.
Pantoja looks tired.
He does. I mean, he really emptied the gas in that first round, the beginning of the second as well.
And that's the question, right? Do you feel like you have to do you at 110% to win a round off the champ? Because you may win that round, but it's a 25-minute fight. If you leave it all in round one, what are you doing round three, four, and five?
Well, it looks like he was convinced he was going to be able to take him out.
Right. And I just caught out of my right eye a little bit of dissension in that ATT corner, a disagreement between the two coaches as to what they want. Pantoja has eaten a ton of big shots in round two.
We're without a doubt looking at a far improved Brandon Moreno. We talked about that championship level experience against Figueiredo, the win over Caicara France. He's a different fighter now.
Yeah.
Yep. He follows the game plan beautifully. Right now, the game plan seems to be that jab. So keeping your hands up and throwing that jab from the right place. Keep him at the edge of that jab and let that dictate the fight.
Also, his speed is still there like it was in the first round. Pantoja's is not.
Right.
Hey, six straight championship fights for Brandon Moreno. That has to mean something.
Definitely, and Pantoja's never realized a fourth round. It's been all title fights for Moreno. Nice short left hook there.
Brandon Moreno has a beautiful jab.
Yeah, he does.
It's so long, and he's got that reach advantage. Look at that one, too. Oh, that jab.
Oh! Big left from Pantoja. Moreno was able to eat it. And now a knee.
Oh, caught the kick and dumped him. Brandon Moreno has so much energy.
What a fight through 10!
Calma. Olha só.
Calm down. Look at me. Look at me. You need to get your hands up because he's really getting you. You need to get the hand up. All right. You shake a little bit, start fainting a little bit, and then start with a straight shot. Okay, start with a straight shot. Look at him. He's stalling a little bit. Okay, you need to move a little more. Listen, look at me. Look at me. Look at you. You started with a jab. You need to go a little bit with overhand and just go up on top. Get him on top. Don't fuck. He's gonna start around strong. You need to defend yourself really well and finish it off strong. Okay, you get it? Okay, it's 1-1.
That double left hand was nice.
Oh my goodness.
Closed captioning for tonight's broadcast is brought to you by Diablo Immortal, Slay Demons with the all-new Vampiric class, Blood Knight, coming to Diablo Immortal on July 13th. Third round of a possible five to decide the UFC flyweight title.
I love the advice from the Pantoja corner. They said, shorten everything up a little bit. Throw something straight and get your hands up.
Tom.
This is terrible, but this is good for Pantoja.
The more time Randy
takes off here, the better it is for Pantoja. Pantoja looked tired and beat up at the beginning of the third. Brandon Moreno looked fresh.
You got a little time here?
And very discouraged.
You okay? You ready to come now?
He looked discouraged.
And Moreno wants to get right back in there. Look.
Let's see if Pantoja listens and gets the hands up. He cannot allow. Oh, nice elbow there by the champion. Oh, good Pantoja. He's got to try to find a way to secure this takedown. It looks like Pantoja got cut on that lead elbow by Moreno.
Yeah, looked like there were two elbows, maybe a step in one as well.
Pantoja's got his back, but Moreno's doing a fantastic job.
He's got the body triangle. Moreno's got to continue to try to move that foot over to the opposite side. Get pressure on that lock. Pantoja has submitted him here before.
Pantoja, one of the best RNC guys in the business.
Brandon's doing a really good job of hand fighting there. Notice him just fighting the hands before Pantoja can get the rear naked choke started. Pantoja's got to try to find a way to settle this guy.
We just got a look at our ISO monitor of two elbows landed by Moreno, one of which caused a big gash.
Moreno's doing a tremendous job of hand fighting here. He is not allowing Pantoja free arms. Pantoja flipped the lock on the body triangle now. Moreno needs to try to move it back to the opposite side. There it is. He's got to watch arm triangle here, though. If he turns back into Pantoja,
Moreno spent a lot of time defending this in camp.
Moreno's out. He's out.
Beautiful.
The moment Moreno got that lock over to the opposite side, he could start to rotate. He did exactly that. Now he lets Pantoja up.
Under 3 minutes to go in round three. Pantoja is wearing it.
And he's busted up.
He's busted up, but Moreno needs to fight his way back into this round. Pantoja with the back control, the takedown. This is a fantastic fight.
I'm telling you.
Boom!
Oh, big left hook.
And I think this would serve Pantoja well. Throw jabs with Brandon Moreno, opposed to trying to throw hooks around his jabs.
Yeah, instead of trying to step in and just land bombs. Oh, high kick. Beautiful high kick.
Beautiful combination by the champion.
Oh!
Oh,
the
man.
Speed of Brandon Moreno.
Body shot from Pantoja.
With that inside low kick to finish it.
Pantoja landed a beautiful body shot there, John. That was a great left hook to the body.
Both guys bloodied and battered.
Pantoja's trying to eat those shots.
Yep, he can't. He cannot eat that many jabs. Pantoja goes to the double leg here. He's got to try to switch to one side. Moreno's doing a fantastic job of collecting underhooks. Pantoja is exhausted, but he's still fighting. Gets another takedown.
Nice
takedown
by Pantoja.
Yes.
Huge.
Brandon Moreno is doing exactly what you need to do. You got to shove the guy towards your feet. Oh, right on the plaza there. Pantoja's too good for that, yeah. Pantoja's way too good a grapple for that.
Pantoja's inside control.
Oh! Pantoja landed an up kick there.
Oh, those elbows.
Yes, they're good elbows.
That's the elbows. He's slicing him across the head.
He's holding that wrist and beating Moreno from the bottom. And here comes Brandon.
What a fight.
What a fight. What a third round. That's Pantoja very smart by Pantoja. Up. Getting back up.
Tremendous spirit and cardio on both sides. Final 30 seconds of round three. Short uppercut gets to the body for Pantoja.
What a round, man.
And here's the thing to consider. We haven't seen Pantoja like this.
No.
We haven't seen him beat up and tested like this. We've seen him in tough fights, but not like this.
Not like this.
And he is about to witness a fourth round for the first time as
beautiful
an MMA pro.
Combination.
But I mean, Pantoja won, I think he won the third round.
Yeah.
He did a good job bouncing back after a terrible second round.
So it might be 2-1.
It might be 2-1 Pantoja.
Bang, aqui.
Look at me, come here, calm down. Listen, this is that time. You won this round, okay? It's 2-1, okay? You can't just go at him. Just go charge, don't charge at him. Just jabs, and then just jab. And just always get up and just start cross. If you're gonna
jab, fuck his timing up. Keep hitting with a jab. Once you get the timing with a jab, start hitting him with a cross. You understand? Stop waiting on him. Brandon, we lost that round probably, you understand me? We lost that round, it's a close fucking fight. Now I need you to start pressing this motherfucker. Don't wait. Look at me, you're fucking ready for this. Let's go, we're ready for this.
Let's take a look at that elbow that cut him, that beautiful up elbow by Brandon Moreno.
All right, round four is brought to you by Manscaped's Lawnmower 4.0, the official electric trimmer of UFC. Visit manscaped.com now. New territory for Pantoja. Familiar spot for the hunted Brandon Moreno.
I love the message from Safe Side. He told Brandon, we lost that round, Brandon, but you're ready for this. He said, we think we lost the round, but you've been here before. Don't rush. Take your time and keep interrupting his timing with the jab.
Pantoja's had some good success with that left hand, right low kick combination. Yep. And it looks crisp. It doesn't look slow like his hands are starting to look. Oh, he stung him with that left hand.
That was a beautiful left hook.
Nice left to the body.
These guys are so good, man.
It's insane to watch.
That jab is just a thing of beauty. Look, there's an elbow again. There's that low kick. That one's stuck.
The one area that Moreno could benefit from is maybe not just box, because right now he's just boxing.
He hurt him with that left hook. This is some rock and sock and roll stuff.
Moreno doesn't kick enough. If he threw more kicks, he might.
Beautiful elbow. Huge takedown. Huge for Pantoja.
Massive takedown. That elbow was nasty right off of a beautiful uppercut by Moreno. Moreno has got to get an underhook right now. You see Pantoja trying to step in the guard, trying to secure him. He wants to have guard, Joe.
Great scramble by Moreno.
Oh, these scrambles are amazing.
High-level mixed martial arts, man.
There's nothing like it, man. Championship stakes. Pantoja 3 of 7 now on his takedown attempts as we come up on 3 minutes here to go in round four.
When you get to watch fighting at this level, man, it's second to none, John. Like you said, he cannot allow Pantoja to take him down to the mat and get that body triangle. That's where Pantoja's found success. He got dragged back to the mat there. See, trying to grapple there, rolling the leg locks and everything, only puts you further into the game that Pantoja wants to play. He wants to grapple. He's having a lot of trouble dealing with the hand speed of Brandon Moreno.
Yes. This is a lot of energy being expended here by Pantoja and by Moreno.
Yes.
But the arms of Pantoja, we were already seeing fatigue in those arms throwing punches. You're going to see a lot more of it if they get out of this exchange.
Well, the one thing we know is that Brandon isn't necessarily a grappler. So this is a bit unfamiliar for him. He's working in areas that he doesn't generally spend much time in the fights. And Pantoja's got him covered, making him carry his weight, and then making him fight the fight that he wants.
Pantoja's on the back.
Moreno's doing a good job of trying to use the fence. He's got to fight the hands of Pantoja.
Both men Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belts, but certainly that is more Pantoja's world historically. Coming up on 90 seconds to go in round four of a possible five.
Yes.
These fans tonight have witnessed one of the greatest cards in UFC history.
But this is a great fight. This is the fight of the night. We've seen some great fights.
This is so close.
Oh, it's so such a good fight. Because Pantoja's resting here. He's taking his time. Brandon has got to find a way to change this. He's got to move. He's got to shift. He's got to get his hips going left to right to try to get Pantoja off of his back. Because Alessandre will stay here for the rest of the round if he can.
Yes, I love how Jason Herzog is just letting them work.
Yes.
He's not involving himself at all.
This is huge for Alessandre Pantoja, getting this fight back to the ground. Arm triangle tip here. Oh, Brandon
changed
position.
Great job by Brandon Moreno. Fantastic job in reversing position. He got greedy going for that arm triangle without controlling the body.
You hear from Hoopito saying, get up.
Right.
He's telling Pantoja he cannot finish this round on the bottom.
Right. Gotta be careful with those up kicks.
Back on the cage.
Very smart by Pantoja.
Yep.
That changes the
wayward shot by Pantoja late in the round.
Big elbow
from Moreno. Warrior spirit
fight
on full display. 5 minutes to go.
It's excellent. Hey, calm down. But look at me. Listen, you won three rounds. You won three rounds. But now, but Dallas is, if you stop fighting, he's going to come strong. He knows he lost three rounds. Now, we need this. We need this. You need this. You need to think of everything you trained, everything you've done for your family. Okay? Do not get into a takedown.
The fucking title is here.
You hear me?
Right now.
Look at me.
Look at me.
Right fucking now.
Despiértate.
Chin down, hands up. Stop. Stay off the fence. When he gets you on the cage, you gotta turn inside. You hear me? Turn inside, don't turn away. Do not fucking let him take you down. I need this 5 fucking minutes right here. The title's on the fucking line.
What a championship fight turned in through 20 minutes by Brandon Moreno and Alessandre Pantoja. DC, I know you like the scorecard business. They could be all over the place. Pantoja could be up 3-1.
Yes, I'm having a conversation with the matchmakers right now. We're lost in the round. We have no idea what round we're in at this point or what round we're scoring. This is a really close fight. It's just even. So that tells you that it may be 2-2, or if it's 3-1 one way, I would feel like a 3-1 Pantoja side.
Look at the live
on the top
odds.
Control.
The live odds are dead even.
Brandon needs to get on the gas, though. He cannot get taken down this round.
He might have to finish Pantoja in this round or have a big round.
Yes. It all comes down to how you scored round four. I thought round three with all the back control, Pantoja won round three, but round four was very close.
He can't let Moreno just pop him on the outside with that jab.
Nope. He can't cruise.
Oh.
Yeah, it was interesting to hear the American Top Team corner suggest to Pantoja that he's up 3-1. You just never know.
You never know. Oh, big left hook by Moreno.
That's a championship fifth round, ladies and gentlemen. Huh. It's going out there and just letting it all hang out. Oh, Pantoja's fighting back to him.
Huge left hand connection by Pantoja.
This is a great fight, man.
An unbelievable fight.
And neither of these guys or anything like this in 2018, right? The evolution on both sides has been marked.
Oh, these are complete world championship caliber fighters now. You go back and watch them on The Ultimate Fighter and then see them now. What an evolution.
I mean, that fight on The Ultimate Fighter was so sloppy. And then the second fight was such one-way traffic for Pantoja. But this guy, Brandon Moreno, has improved to the next level. But Alessandro Pantoja is so good, man. His team said all week, the longer you wait to fight him, the worse it's going to get.
Under 3 minutes to decide the world title champ.
Sorry, John. That's proven to be true because he is a handful. But so is Brandon Moreno.
Pantoja appears unfinishable. His MMA record suggests as much.
He's getting popped, though.
Yeah.
He's getting popped with that left, the jab, the hook.
Some of the shots that he has taken tonight tells you how tough he is.
Moreno's doing such a good job of timing that elbow as Pantoja tries to close and punch. Good left hook by Moreno again. Again.
Oh,
he gets it. Oh, my goodness.
Look at the significant strikes in round five. 18-18. That's exactly what this whole fight has been.
That's interesting because I sort of felt like Moreno was getting the better of the exchanges.
Me too. I felt like Brandon was landing more with the jab.
He certainly was landing the more significant shots.
It's 18-18. But here's the deal, right? We all know a jab is significant.
Yes.
We don't know if they're counting that as a significant strike.
Well, it's certainly significant.
Yeah, it is.
Especially the way he's throwing it.
Striking numbers exceedingly close. Pantoja, on the strength of 6 takedowns on 11 attempts, has controlled a lot of the grappling. Some tremendous escapes and scrambles from Moreno.
But like this position right here, where Pantoja's on his back, how are you valuing that? Because he's not throwing anything. He's
but
not
he
landing.
Now.
He is controlling
some left hooks now.
Yes. He's got to throw some strikes here.
And this is exhausting for your legs to carry yourself like this.
In the fifth round?
Yes.
After the damage he's taken?
Yeah. He's high on the hip, though. So he's kind of like almost sitting on the hip.
The Pantoja corner desperately wants him to maintain this position for the final minute.
58 seconds left.
Of a title fight they'll be talking about for the ages.
And that's the thing about 125, right? When you have a fight like that, you easily go rematch if you want. And then it's like people are sitting, just like with Figueiredo and Moreno.
Right.
Pantoja's got his right arm across the face. He's going gable grip.
Moreno looks like he's controlling the opposite hand, but he's got 2-on-1 on that choke hand. And Herzog has done a fantastic job just letting these guys work.
Amazing job.
He has not.
Certainly had the right referee allowing the fighters to compete.
Yes.
Down the stretch we come.
He has not tried to make himself a part of the fight. He's done an amazing job of letting these guys determine who's going to be the flyweight champion of the world.
Now, how do you score this round? Because
that's what I'm saying.
You know, even strikes, but the damage we felt was Brandon Moreno with that jab. I think Pantoja might have pulled it off.
But even all the ground control, right? That means something.
It means something.
A rivalry renewed 5 years after the previous meeting, and both guys with elevated games put on a 25-minute war for the UFC Flyweight Championship. Brandon Moreno came in the incumbent. Alexandre Pantoja could very well be headed back to South Florida as the newly minted UFC Flyweight champ.
That is a real world championship fight. Real world championship caliber performance by both fighters.
Yeah.
Absolutely tremendous.
It was a tremendous performance by both guys, Joe. And, J.A., if I got to be honest with you, this is what championship-level mixed martial arts should look like.
My goodness.
Two guys so evenly matched, both guys so skilled and well-prepared. Just tremendous. I mean, here's a recap of what I believe is the fight of the year to this point. Left hook from Pantoja lands early. Drops Moreno. Wins round one very convincingly. Brandon Moreno comes back in the second round and fights like an absolute savage. Behind the jab, just putting it on Pantoja. Round two is a beautiful round by Brandon Moreno. Look at that beautiful double left. He went body left hook. Both of them land square. And then again, it was the jab. You can see the damage on the face of Moreno from the jab of Pantoja. Beautiful lead elbow by the champion. A left hook lands for Pantoja. Another lead elbow lands for Brandon Moreno. Moreno with another jab. Pantoja started to throw jabs with Moreno as the fight went on. Right here, a beautiful takedown by Pantoja. Shoots a double leg, elevates that right underhook and runs through the position, finishing with a knee tap, which ultimately kept him on the back for the rest of the fight.
All right, so here are the numbers. Significant strike, slight edge for Moreno. They threw nearly the identical number of significant strikes. 253 for Moreno, 254 for Pantoja. Pantoja did have the one knockdown. He had the six takedowns, countered by the three reversals for Brandon Moreno. We knew more about Brandon Moreno coming in here in terms of the championship medal. We learned a lot about Pantoja and his all-around game and toughness tonight. All right, here now for the official decision is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. Ben Cartlidge scores the contest, 49-46, Moreno. Derek Cleary scores it, 48-47, Pantoja. And Junichiro Camijo scores the contest, 48-47, for the winner by split decision, and champion of the world, Alexandre the Cannibal Pantoja.
What an absolutely epic fight.
Can't touch this. Can't touch this. Can't touch this.